This is primarily a women's issue. It's her decision. It may shape, and usually does shape, her whole future, personal life and family life, and has a crucial enjoyment, a crucial impact on her enjoyment of all the other rights, whether it be to education for girls, whether it be an economic activity for women, whether it be family situations. It impacts every aspect of a woman's life. But we're not only talking about women's rights, we're talking also about utilitarian arguments. The World Health Organization has shown, not a feminist organization, health organization, has shown that in countries where induced termination of pregnancy is restricted by law, safe termination of pregnancy is a privilege of the rich, while women with limited resources have little choice but to resort to unsafe providers and practices. So this results in severe economic discrimination, discrimination against poor women. There's a lot of hypocrisy here, because as we saw with senators in the US Senate who have procured abortions for their mistresses and then go out and fight against abortion for women, what they're saying is, if you're rich, you can have one. If you're poor, you can't. And we have seen also, which I'll come back to, that the World Health Organization has shown that actually prohibition of abortion does not stop termination of pregnancy in terms of the incidence of procedures in the countries concerned. So it's not just some kind of luxury argument about women's choices. This goes much further.